بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى أصحابه أجمعين. وبعد، I have compiled a list of statements from the well-known scholars of past and present والحمدلله regarding those who rule by other than what Allah has revealed. And as you will see, inshallah, this is nothing short of the destruction of the Takfiri ideology والحمدلله. So to begin, Ibn Kathir in his famous Tafsir, Rahimahullah, he says in the chapter entitled Another Reason Behind Revealing These Honorable Ayat, Abdul Razak said, Mu'amir narrated to us that Tawus said that Ibn Abbas was asked about Allah's statement, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. And whosoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, then such are the disbelievers. He said, quote, it's an act of kufr. Ibn Tawus added, it is not like those who disbelieve in Allah, His angels, His books, and His messengers. End quote. To repeat, it is not like those who disbelieve in Allah, His angels, His books, and His messengers. Authority narrated that Ibn Jurayj said that Atta said there is kufr and kufr less than kufr, dhulm and dhulm less than dhulm, fisk and fisk less than fisk. Continuing, Waqi' said that Sa'd al-Makki said that Tawus said that وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. And whosoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, such are the disbelievers. This is not the kufr that annuls one's religion. This is not the kufr that annuls one's religion. Ali bin Abi Talha also stated that Ibn Abbas commented on Allah's statement, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. And whosoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, such are the disbelievers. Quote, whoever rejects what Allah has revealed will have committed kufr. And whoever accepts what Allah has revealed but did not rule by it is a zalim, unjust, and a fasik, a rebellious, and a sinner. Ibn Jarir recorded this statement. So to repeat, whoever rejects what Allah has revealed will have committed kufr. And whoever accepts what Allah has revealed but did not rule by it is a zalim, an unjust and a fasik, rebellious and a sinner. Ibn Jarir recorded this statement. So Ibn Abbas was asked about Allah's statement, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ to the end, and whosoever does not judge. He said, quote, it is an act of kufr. Ibn Tawus added, it is not like those who disbelieve in Allah, His angels, His books, and His messengers. Authority narrated that Ibn Jurayj said that Atta said there is kufr and kufr less than kufr, dhulm and dhulm less than dhulm, fisk and fisk less than fisk. And whosoever does not judge by what Allah has revealed, such are the disbelievers. Al-Bara' bin Azib, Hudhayfa bin al-Yaman, Ibn Abbas, Abu Mijlas, Abu Raja, Ikrama, Ubaidullah bin Abdullah, Al-Hasan al-Basri and others said that this ayah was revealed about the people of the book. Al-Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah, added that this ayah also applies to us. Abdul Razak said that authority said that Mansur said that Ibrahim said that these ayat were revealed about the children of Israel, and Allah accepted them for this ummah. Ibn Jarir recorded this statement. And then in another chapter from the Tafsir entitled The Pardon is Expiation for Such Offenses, Ibn Kathir narrates Allah's statement, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And whosoever does not judge by that which Allah has revealed, such are the unjust. Earlier we mentioned the statement of Atta' and Tawus, that there is kufr and lesser kufr, injustice and lesser injustice, and fisk and lesser fisk. And this ayah was actually revealed when two groups of Jews had a dispute and they were warring and they were fighting. And in order to resolve their dispute, they wanted to refer back to the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This is why this verse was originally revealed, because of these two tribes of the Jews, which is detailed in the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he uses the example of Najashi, and he said, and this was the state of An-Najashi, ruler of Habashi. Even though he was the king of the Christians, his people did not follow him in accepting Islam. Rather, only a number of them accepted Islam with him. And for this, when he died, there was no one to pray over him. So the Prophet ﷺ prayed over him in Medina. He went out with the Muslims to the Musalla and arranged them in rows, and prayed over him and informed them of the death, the day he died. He ﷺ said, verily, a righteous brother of yours from the people of Al-Habashi has died, and many of the outwardly manifested pillars of Islam, or most of them, he did not establish upon his people because of his weakness in that. So Najashi did not do hijra, nor did he fight jihad, nor did he perform the hajj. It has even been narrated that he did not even establish his 5 daily prayers, and he did not fast in Ramadan. Neither did he pay the legislated zakat. All of these are obligatory actions, because that would have made apparent to his people, and they would have disapproved of it, opposing him. And it was not possible for him to differ with them. We know definitely that it was not possible for him to judge between his people with the Quran, even though Allah had made it an obligation upon the Prophet ﷺ in Medina, that if the people of the book came to him, then he should not judge between them except with what Allah has revealed to him. And this is taken from Minhaj al-Sunnah, Volume 2, pages 112 to 113. Okay, and all of that was from Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. So Najashi, he didn't fast and pray zakat, even reports that he didn't pray, he didn't make hijrah, and he was still a believer, testified to by the Prophet ﷺ himself. So from the statement of Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, we can clearly understand that Najashi did not rule by what Allah had revealed, and that if one does not deny, reject, opposes, or makes halal what Allah made haram, or vice versa, with belief, that it is an obligation to judge by what Allah has revealed, then such an individual is a believer, even if he does not judge by what Allah has revealed out of weakness, fear, hope, etc. This is because the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, your brother in Habashi has died. Your brother in Habashi has died. Then he prayed over him, which he would not say or do if An-Najashi was a kafir. Another statement from Ibn Taymiyyah, that the Takfiris and the Kharijis love to mistranslate, is the following. And the correct translation is here, and we will show you why also. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, said, and it is known by necessity in the deen of the Muslims and by agreement of all the Muslims that whoever, and the word used here is sawagha, which means considers it permissible. Whoever considers it permissible to follow a sharia other than the sharia of Muhammad, then he is a kafir. And it is like the kufr of the one who believes in some of the book and disbelieves in some of the book. And this is from Al-Fatawa, Volume 28, page 528. The Takfiris will mistranslate the word sawagha into follows, meaning whoever follows other than the sharia, right away he's a kafir. And Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, says, hence, whoever declares it permissible to judge amongst the people with what he considers to be justice, without following what Allah has revealed, then he is a disbeliever. Whoever declares it permissible. Here's a narration about Hatib ibn Balta, a companion, radiallahu anhu, where he informed the Quraysh to be aware that the Prophet ﷺ was going to attack Mecca. Okay, he actually informed the enemies of Islam of the plans of the Muslims, of the plans of the Prophet ﷺ. And let's see how this turns out. So when Allah gave this information to the Prophet ﷺ, he summoned Hatib and Umar radiallahu anhum. Umar said, radiallahu anhu, "Let me take off the head of this munafiq, O Messenger of Allah." End quote. The Messenger refused and asked Hatib, "Why did you do this?" He replied, "O Messenger of Allah, verily I did not do this out of disbelief. I believe Allah is going to aid you. All the companions here have relatives to take care of their families in Mecca.